Now I will show you, there is one Muslim spokesperson, Dr. Zakir Naik. He, as well as entire Muslims, believe that God is formless, bodiless. He doesn't have body. And to prove his statement, to prove his knowledge, Dr. Zakir Naik has taken support of Vedas and Upanishads. I will show you from the discourses of Dr. Zakir Naik ji, as well as from the books made from his discourses, as to how he believes God is. There is one book written by Dr. Zakir Naik, Similarities Between Islam and Hinduism. I will show you. This book is exactly copied from his video cassettes. Look at this book of Dr. Zakir Naik, Similarities Between Islam and Hinduism. Similarities Between Islam and Hinduism, Dr. Zakir Naik. Translator is A.M. Fahim. It is printed from here. This is the complete detail. Copyright 2008. It is printed from here. Latest edition 2012, published by A.M. Fahim, Al Hasanat Books Private Limited. Whatever is written in this book is the entire responsibility of the writer. If someone wants to understand anything or there is some objection, then they can contact the writer of this book, Dr. Zakir Naik, on these numbers. These are fax numbers printed by HS Offset Printers, Chandni Mahal, New Delhi 11002. On page number 12, Hinduism, it's page 12, Hinduism, Tasavvur-e-Ilah. In Hinduism, we come here on page number 13, here, to support his knowledge. He has taken a reference of Shvetashwar Upanishad, chapter 4:20, from Nasamdarshi. Here is the Sanskrit. Pure Sanskrit is also not written. Translation is on next page. On page 14, it's written, his face cannot be seen. No one can see him from eyes. Okay. Because this is their baseless knowledge. Here, they have given reference of Srimad Bhagavad Gita, chapter number 7, verse number 20. Bhagavad Gita is the most popular book amongst Hindus. It is written in Bhagavad Gita, chapter number 7, verse number 20. Those whose wisdom is overshadowed by material desires, they worship fake gods. Ardh means incomplete gods. They have said the meaning of Ardh as the fake or dummy god. I will show you that also. Now what they say from Yajurveda chapter number 32, verse number 3, they took Natasya Pratima Asti. There is no statue of that god. He wants to prove that God is formless, and Dr. Zakir Naik ji wants to say that your Hindu books do support him, that there is no form of God, there is no form. Look next. In same context, it is said, by referring Yajurveda chapter number 40, verse number 8, that there is no body of him. He is pure. Okay. We only take this much from this book. Now I will show you in English as it is. Look at his speech. Look. Similarities between Hinduism and Islam. Dr. Zakir Naik. Similarities between Hinduism and Islam by Dr. Zakir Naik. Farid Book Depot Private Limited. Similarities between Hinduism and Islam, Dr. Zakir Naik, edition 2008. Price is Rs. 40. Farid Book printed by Muhammad Nasir Khan. Farid Book Depot Private Limited. Street Patodi House, Darya Ganj, New Delhi. Branch detail is given, printed in Farid Enterprises, Delhi 6. Okay. We are at page number 10 of this book. We will read from here. Bhagavad Gita, chapter number 7. The most popular amongst all Hindu scriptures is the Bhagavad Gita. The Bhagavad Gita mentions in chapter 7, verse 20, what have they tried to prove by referring this is those whose intelligence has been stolen by material desires worship demigods. They worship incomplete gods, that is, those who are materialistic. They worship God, demigods, that is, others as deities besides the true God. The idea is few Hindus worship true God, that is Brahma, but most Hindus worship demigods, that is, incomplete gods. Dr. Zakir Naik ji says, Muslims worship complete God. They believe the knowledge giver of Quran Sharif as the complete God. And others, most Hindus worship demigods, that is, incomplete gods of incomplete Allah, pious souls. In Surat Furqani, chapter 25, ayat number 52 to 59, the knowledge giver of Quran Sharif says, He is Allahu Akbar, who created the entire universe in 6 days and sat on throne on the seventh day. Ask about him from an enlightened saint, means the knowledge giver of Quran Sharif also doesn't have knowledge about that complete God. He himself doesn't know his way of worship, then what will he tell you? With this, it is proved that the knowledge giver of Quran Sharif is also demigod, not the complete God. You are mistaken. Come to the slave, I have complete God's complete spiritual way of worship, complete spiritual knowledge. You will get salvation as well as your children will. The whole world will be liberated. Now the concept which the slave wants to clear is that they, Muslims, in fact the whole world, believe God is formless due to lack of correct spiritual knowledge. Since today's discourse is on Muslim religion, so Muslims believe God is bodiless, formless. They call him Bechun. Next, see, they made the concept clear that what I say, what Dr. Zakir Naik ji says, he has taken reference of some verses of Vedas to support himself, and he claims Vedas also tell the same and Hindus have translated it. I will show you those discourses in which he has taken that support in this book. English edition, Similarities Between Hinduism and Islam. This is Dr. Zakir Naik's book. We are reading on page number 10. We read this about demigods, what is said in Yajurved chapter number 40, verse number 8, it is mentioned in Yajurved chapter 40, verse 8, He is bodiless and pure. Means God is bodiless, He doesn't have a body, and He is pure. Look now, this is Khud Baat Dr. Zakir Naik, means Dr. Zakir Naik's own words, Hindi translation, Maulana Muhammad, Imran Kasmi, Vigyanvi, Farid Book Depot, Delhi, safe for copyright, book name, Khud Baat Dr. Zakir Naik, Urdu translation, Sayyid Rohan Shah, Tartib and Compilation, Amar Shaheed, Hindi translation, Maulana Muhammad Imran Kasmi, coordinator is Alhaz Muhammad Nasir Khan, quantity 2100, publication October 2011, Imran Computers Private Limited, publisher Farid Book Depot Private Limited, 2158 MP Street, Patodi House, Daryaganj, New Delhi. Now see, on page 186 it is said, He cannot be seen, no one can see Him from eyes. Look here. Khud Baat Dr. Zakir Naik, page number 187, Tasavvur of God in World's Religion. Look here. He is bodiless and true. It is illustrated in Yajurved chapter number 40, verse number 8. He is illuminated without body, without injury, not physical. He is so pure that even Satan cannot peep in. Okay, God is formless. Even Hazrat Muhammad Ji has also supported this. Look at this book, Hazrat Muhammad Salal, Indian Religious Granth. From where is it? Writer is Dr. M. A. Shrivastav, Madhur Sandesh Sangam. It is printed from New Delhi, Madhur Sandesh Sangam is the publisher. All this. Name is Hazrat Muhammad Salal, Indian Religious Granth. Writer is Dr. M. A. Shrivastav. Publisher, Madhur Sandesh Sangam, E20 Abul Fazal Enclave, Jamia Nagar, New Delhi 110025. Phone number, address is MI Publishers, D307, Abul Fazal Enclave, Jamia Nagar, New Delhi 110025. Printer is HS Offset Printers, New Delhi 110021. I will show you on page number 6. What is told, you, that is Salal Hazrat Muhammad Ji, told there is only one God of humans who is formless. Okay. Referring this, even Dr. Zakir Naik Ji says in Yajurved chapter number 40, verse number 8, God is told as bodiless. Dr. Zakir Naik Ji says this, but in Yajurved chapter number 40, verse number 8, merely Akaya or Akayam is not mentioned. The meaning of Shukram Akayam Asana Viram is that his body is not made from parents' combination, not made from semen. His body doesn't have nerves. He is self-made. He is Paribhu. It's mentioned in that verse. Then too, Dr. Zakir Naik Ji and Hazrat Muhammad Ji believe God is formless. Dr. Zakir Naik Ji means that God is formless, bodiless, no one can see Him. Who can see a formless?
But pious souls, what is the reality? God is in man form, same as humans. He has body. His name is Kabir. And he resides in ultimate abode. He speedily comes here in body, imparts actual knowledge. I will show you in Vedas, and Dr. Zakir Naik ji believes God is formless. So with this, it is proved that he is not wise. He himself is confused and is confusing all humans and Muslim community. It is said about Dr. Zakir Naik ji that he got 40,000 Hindus converted to Islam religion. So pious souls, if his path was correct, we would have happily followed him. We need God no matter what we become. But for those Hindus, it's fit to say the adage is, got stuck in dates while falling from sky, but their situation is like, fell from dates and hung in sky. They got stuck at even more wrong place without knowledge. It gets